Good afternoon, friends and family. This is Gail Manizak with City Changers Illinois, and I want to speak a little bit about faith. Amen? All of us need to have faith. Without faith, we cannot please God. So faith is what God treasures most in each and every one of us. You know, it says in James chapter 2, Abraham believed God, and it was accounted unto him for righteousness. We have to see that a man is justified by works and not by faith only. So this and many other similar verses to this say exactly the very same thing. So the faith, or that faith of ours, is very important to God. Abraham is the only man in the Bible who's called a friend of God. So you know what, how do you think he earned this title? I talked about this a little bit the other day. It was really profound. Just thinking about Abraham's life. And actually, we've been in Genesis studying about Abraham and Sarah. Right now, we're in that area of actually down to about Isaac and Rachel. So anyway, you know, he wasn't a perfect man because twice he offered up his own wife as his sister in order to basically save his own neck. So, you know, why was he called a friend of God? I believe because Abraham was a man of faith. He was a successful farmer. But when God told him to leave everything and go to an unknown destination, he didn't hesitate. He just did it. He had faith in God's promises to give him a son, and God finally did give him a son. We all know that, by the name of Isaac. And when God requested Abraham to give Isaac back, Abraham did not question the Lord again. Amen. And he gave Isaac back. So, you know, that is totally complete and utter faith in God. God was so touched that he called Abraham his friend. So, you know, when we pray, it's often just like, seems like one way, you know, and us talking to God, but with Abraham, it was not that way. It was a two-way street. He loved and obeyed God. He listened to his voice. He really was the father of faith. So I'd like to encourage you to just increase your faith so that God can call you his friend. Amen? And then I always thought that it actually took courage to say yes to God's call to just give all of our possessions to the poor and go into the mission field. But then as I got older, as I began to grow, as I began to learn, I realized it takes more faith to say no sometimes. So it takes immense courage to swim against the current, right? To stand up and say, no, not me and not my family. We don't do that. We serve the Lord. So we often kind of shake under the fear of man. And that kind of fear just might persuade you not to speak out against evil. And it does. I've seen it do that to people. And then because of their fear of man, and then to instead go with the flow. It's easier to go with the flow, you know, just float along right with him. And you know, but the brave person, the person that has courage and is brave, is going to stand up for the Lord no matter what. He's not going to fear man. Even if he does fear man, he's still going to cross over that line, stand up, be brave and courageous. And more than likely, if he has any fear of man, like even I myself, I'm not saying I have a bunch of fear of man, but I'm saying I have to pray for courage. I have to pray for boldness in many areas of my life. I'm not always feeling so brave or feeling so bold. But, you know, we can pray, and the Lord is definitely, he's going to help us. So, a lot of times we can let people sway us, but we don't have to. We don't have to follow man. You know, the Bible says that the blind lead the blind, or that is not even the scription, something about the blind and they all fall into the ditch or something like that, and I can't even remember offhand where it is. But without faith, we can't please God. We must believe that He exists and that He wants those of us who believe to diligently seek Him. The Lord has told us that in the Word. And sometimes, you know what? You can tell people God doesn't answer prayer, and they usually get very uncomfortable. And then you could say, you know what? God answers the prayer of faith. You know, He's not going to answer anybody who is not walking in faith. And then again, I can't see why anybody would be asking God something if they didn't have a little bit of faith. So personally, I believe everybody has faith, because the Bible says that everyone has been given a mustard seed grain of faith. So you see, it's in believing that we receive. It's all about believing. Believing that Jesus is the Son of God. Believing that He is a miracle worker. Believing that He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Having faith in God puts Him in the right place at the forefront of our lives. So in Luke chapter 8, verse 48, it says, "Your faith has made you well." So this sick woman, she knew that if she could just touch the hem of His garment, that she would be healed. And she was. And then a similar thing happened. We know about blind Bartimaeus, the blind man. He was determined to make sure that Jesus heard him when he was walking past. So he shouted loudly, making basically kind of a fool of himself. But eventually Jesus stopped, and Jesus asked, "What do you want me to do for you?" So when Bartimaeus asked Jesus for his sight, he received it immediately and he was healed. Jesus told him, "Your faith, it's your faith that has made you well." It's our faith in Jesus. It's our faith in what Jesus has done for us. So, you know, if we feel like our faith is not enough, how do we increase our faith? We ask God for it, just as the disciples did. Amen. You know, there was one person in the Bible, and he said, "I believe, but help thou my unbelief." So he knew that maybe he didn't quite have enough faith to exert out there. So all of us know the story of Jesus also feeding the 5,000, feeding 5,000 people with only 5 loaves and 2 fishes. And it was a little boy in that story that gave him this, his little lunch. You know, probably had just a basic little lunch for one little boy. And Jesus could take that and feed everyone who had come to hear him preach. So believe it or not, you too have loaves and fishes the Lord wants to transform. Whatever we give to Jesus, amen, let's look at it this way. You give your talents, you give your anything that he tells you to give. You know, give your heart, give your testimony. And Jesus is going to transform that into just eternal things. You know, I want to say eternal purposes. That's what your testimony is. We can believe God for the impossible, just as that boy did. Jesus said in Luke 18, he said, "Assuredly, I say to you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will by no means enter it." So if you were to ask a grown man or woman whether it would be possible to feed 5,000 men, plus women and children, with only 2 small fish and 5 barley loaves, they would tell you it's impossible. And they would be right. It is impossible. And that's exactly why we call it a miracle. Amen? So as the boy gave to Jesus, as he gave to Jesus, let us do that. Let us give Jesus our life. Give him your life. Give him your family. Give him your vision for the future with no strings attached. Just let go of everything. Give him everything. Give him everything, and he will give back to you. And what does the Bible say? Pressed down, shaken together, and running over. So, you know, we can give God thanks for that, because that's exactly what he's doing with our life. What we give to him, he uses everything for the kingdom's sake as to what we give to him. Amen? So we can give him thanks every single day for using our life for his purposes, as we've asked him to do, most of us. Most of us are not out there ministering in churches or even speaking on YouTube or doing anything that we don't want God to multiply it and win the lost. Amen? We want to see people come to know God like we know God. We want to see those that are sick healed. The Bible says the signs, wonders, and miracles will follow those that believe. So as we look at our life, it's like, you know what, God? Our signs, wonders, and miracles follow me. I'm not seeing that as much as I want to see that, or I feel like I should be seeing that. But, you know, I just encourage you today to press on, because God has a good purpose for your life, a beautiful purpose for your life, but you've got to lay a lot of other things down and follow Jesus. You can't be out sinning and living your old life, your old carnal life, like it was before you knew him, and expect that signs, wonders, and miracles are going to follow you. Amen? You got to give him, like I said a minute ago, give him your family, give him your life, give him your vision, your future, with no strings attached. None. And I'll close here and just say God bless you, each one.